Although using the standard error of the estimate can help us assess the accuracy of our predictions, we can make even more accurate predictions by computing confidence intervals for our predicted values, our y-hats. In other words, when we get our regression line, we have our expected value, which is this y-hat naught, for a specified value, x-naught. However, the actual value might be anything from up here to down here, or it might be exactly equal to our predicted value. Therefore, we might want a confidence interval around our expected value for where the actual value might be. Similarly, we might want a confidence interval for the true slope. We'll have a certain regression line, and we'll have calculated the slope for that regression line based on our sample data. And this is just an example. The slope could be this, or flatter down to here. A confidence interval for slope can tell us the range for which the true population slope might be. You won't actually calculate the confidence interval in this lesson, because we're going to assume that you'll use a computer to get it. The important thing is that you know what it means. For example, let's say we have some sample data that looks like this. We calculate that the regression line is y equals bx plus a, some slope and some intercept. But let's say then that we're able to look at all the population data, and it looks like this. Now it looks to be slightly downward sloping. Since we're assuming this is the true regression line, we'll use the common notation for the regression coefficients for the population. Oh, and these should have hats since they're the predicted values. If this were the case, where the sample regression line is positively sloping, but the true regression line for the population is negatively sloping, that would mean that the confidence interval for B has a negative lower bound and a positive upper bound. It includes zero within this range. Therefore, if we run a two-tailed hypothesis test for whether or not the slope is equal to zero, we would fail to reject the null, meaning there's no evidence that there's a linear relationship between x and y, based on that sample. In fact, let's get more into hypothesis testing for slope.